Here we go. Welcome everyone to the first 10 by 10 on Zoom. It's so great that so many of you are here supporting the show and especially supporting the Dance Palace.
Here are a few reminders so that your Zoom experience is the best.
I'm not getting that sound.
Please stay muted.
Yes, it's definitely started. No, it is. It's been playing.
So everyone, would you please make sure that you are muted? Because if you're not, we all hear you. And it's especially when the performers get performing, it will be very distracting. If you have any questions or comments, please type them into the chat box, which is at the bottom of the big box. If you get a notice on your screen that your connection is unstable, you can try turning off your video, closing any open tabs or programs that are running on your device, and possibly using the personal hotspot on your phone to connect.
All right. For over half of the audience tonight, you will be experiencing the 10 by 10 show for the very first time. So for those of you who don't know,
For those of you who don't know, we have rules. We have rules. And the first one is 10 by 10 performance lab is 10 performances that last 10 minutes or less each. When the 10 minutes are up, the performance is over.
10 by 10 performance lab is a place to do brave work, to take risks, and to play.
It's an opportunity for artists to test new work or a new direction in front of a supportive audience. That would be all of you who are watching.
Yes, and it's an opportunity for the audience to be part of the creative process. We encourage you to hang out after the show to give feedback to the performers. Consider what drew you in and possibly what kept you out.
Oh. And during the middle of the show, we open the stage up to an audience member who would like to do something, anything, on stage for 1 minute.
Or as we say nowadays, on Zoom, as we don't, this is our stage. And now, without further ado, on.
On with the show.
All right. So, our first performer tonight is Aura Tantadel Lopez. Butterfly Pieces is a dance performance experiment to transition through change. She was diagnosed with post-concussion syndrome, PCS, and this is her way to share and transform her own experience. Please welcome Aura Tantadel Lopez.
I am wind and earth with butterfly pieces. Soy tierra y viento con pedazos de mariposa. I want to ease the pain and let go. Quiero soltarlo todo y calmar el dolor. To be free, to be me. Ser libre, ser yo. There and now, here and then. Allá y ahora, entonces y aquí. I want to believe that it is possible to heal. Quiero creer que es posible sanar. I want to feel like a wild horse and a giant redwood tree. I want to run on a hill, ride my bike in the wind, swim in all the possible waters and get rid of this pain. I do not want to hear another judgment, another fear-filled comment. I want to become that butterfly that flies back to Mexican mountains every autumn. Quiero sentirme como un caballo salvaje y un árbol de secoya gigante. Correr en la montaña, andar en bicicleta junto al viento, nadar en todas las aguas posibles y quitarme este dolor. No quiero escuchar otro juicio, otro comentario tan lleno de miedo. Convertirme en esa mariposa que cada otoño vuela de vuelta a las montañas mexicanas.
Thank you. Thank you. you.
Thank you so much, Aura. That really was moving. So the next person up is Emily Kuenstler. Emily writes, paints, and performs, and tonight offers a performance piece based on emails she has received. And we're looking for her.
I like your product ideas and pastries.
Emily, you need to
talk on your skin. Visualize light. That's what we're made of. Somewhere. Sounds true. Just sent me a talk about this, which I'll forward. Love. Just read this email. I could have sent you home with some lemon balm and skullcap. That's what I'm drinking now. And gee whiz, there's valerian in my garden, which I'm happy to share. Knockout for most folk. I've just got on to melatonin myself. Now time for a bath. Love ya. Wow, seeing is believing. Thank you, Emily. I wasn't paying full attention to anything but heard some good thoughts. Sounds, but more pre-thought. Many ideas at first light this AM want to write. I want your poetry. Good. Oh yeah, how about that? I can always draw a small skull and crossbones on the label. Figured out my costume, all set to go. I talked to Dylan. Did I already tell you? He sounds like a good one, but he's doing caregiving for his mom tomorrow. Thanks for liniment and pumpkin cornbread. I like your creations. You go. That was when I thought you said Sunday, which works for me. Whoops, with the big letters. Out here, it's beautiful. Clear sky, jellyfish. Bright stars at night. Lots of birds talking, flying. Thanks, I've been thinking of you. I'm well now. Stay warm. Avoid tests. Enjoy breathing. So much beauty. Don't know nothing about it, being a homebody of late. Go out and find out. You never know. Yes, food exaggerated and with tongues and cheeks for performance, a jumping off place. Apples keep falling. I'm getting fat eating so many. Stay well and hi to mom. I need to put what's on the ground out for the deer that whenever falls next is pretty good each morning. We have a pole for picking plus various sticks for prodding good ones. Ready, lots of them. I'll want to hear more about drawing at the San Francisco Art Institute. You sure cover a lot of ground. Once I'm dog free, meanwhile, plenty of subject matter all over the place here. Thank you for being the busy garden helper. Just discovered the 3 bags of usable fruit in bags on the driveway. Wow, lots of stooping and schlepping. Thank you again. Hope you took some good lookers home. As Dog and I were passing by, and I noticed, I picked up one a deer had started. Ambrosia. So sweet and so juicy. Perfect dessert after heavy meal of greasy chicken. And many are not perfect and will make more deer happy. There are herds of quail around here anyway. They will happily wipe out any itty-bitty sprouts. Kaboom. I'd keep them inside a while, then pick the strongest looking ones to put in your beds or containers. Thanks for the amazing job of sorting these apples, Wonder Woman. And then I say, I want all the apples. Good, because there are an endless supply through November. Today I intended to make huckleberry-laced applesauce, got as far as picking another basketful. They need to be used, pronto. Cause spoilage comes from waiting, thinking, space, to gain the feeling of time enough. Yes, and I may be breathing, maybe. We'll bring apples this aft. Also small jar of unsweetened huckleberry applesauce. 'Twould be fun to cut up apples together. Kind of too solo over here. Can we set that up? Me and my mom come early Saturday morning, cut apples, and today I've got some stuff to do. Hello, you all. Thought you might be interested. Guns and Butter was a show I regarded highly. It was discontinued by the current board, which in my view needs to be replaced. If I go, it'll probably be on Wednesday. Trying to convince daughter to go along. Not sure my car, dog, nor I are up for the haul. Quien sabe? 350.org doesn't have anything about marching and calling in sick, i.e. a general climate strike. Not my pears, but and I have some too. They fall like the apples. Plop, plop, plop. Post-hormonally yours, M. Just left a phone message about apples and Sherry's art, which I have on hand and am unloading from the car. Apples I'll bring tomorrow to library, M. Have better apples. See you soon. Don't work too hard. Thanks. You are now in my tattered book. Even if I'm here, you can pick apples, but hope to catch you soon. Anyhow, we have surplus apples. Maybe it would be fun to make apple pies or turnovers together. Inverness Fair this Saturday or pop-up apple pie stand. Quien sabe? It is still a little early in the season, but actually lots are falling. Day by day, sometime tomorrow would be great. Apples will be more plentiful and sweeter as time goes along. Great to visit with you on the ground today. We can skip the Inverness Fair this time, but apple pie business at your place, altogether possible. Oh my God. I'm all about your birthday coffee on the beach and viewing your work in progress. Oh yeah, we'll love to work with you choreographically. Ha! Spell check, didn't redline that. Hang in there. We will do performance. It is fun. Thing tonight could be interesting, inspiring, at least on what not to do. My hunch, there won't be any problem getting in. But what do I know?
All right. Thank you, Emily Kuenstler. That was something to put me into my dream place tonight, I guess. We'll see how that goes. Thanks, Emily Kuenstler. And coming up next to the 10 by 10 Zoom stage is Banana of the Youngbloods. Banana has lived in Inverness for the past 50 years and almost doesn't consider himself a newcomer. He has played at the Station House Cafe more times than he can remember, and he will miss it dearly. Please welcome Banana.
Howdy, folks. Oh, there I am. Look at that. Well, thank you for supporting the Dance Palace, and be sure and support your local newspaper and radio station as well. In strangers if they're haggard. We can't think of anyone to hate. We don't watch commercials in Olima. We don't buy the plastic crap they sell. We still wear our hair long like folks used to. And we bathe often, therefore we don't smell. And I'm proud to be a hippie from Olima, where we're friendly to the squares and all the straight. We still take in strangers if they're ragged. We can't think of anyone to hate. We don't throw our beer cans on the highway. We won't slide a man because he's black. And we don't spill our oil out in the ocean. We love the birds and the fish too much for that. And I'm proud to be a hippie from Olina, where we're friendly to the squares and all the straights. We still take in strangers if they're ragged. We can't think of anyone to hate. We still love our neighbors in Olima. We still dig the sunshine and the stars. We won't send our sons off to the slaughter. And we don't give a damn about going to the moon or Mars. I'm proud to be a hippie from Olima, where we're friendly to the squares and all the straights. We still take in strangers if they're ragged. Can't think of anyone to hate. Now we might smoke marijuana if we wanna. Now and then a trip on LSD. We still burn Old Glory down at the White House, cause we like living right and being free. And I'm proud to be a hippie from Olima, where we're friendly to the squares and all the straights. We still take in strangers if they're haggard. In Olima, California, planet Earth. There you go, folks. Good old Katrina. Yeah.
Jerry.
And Jerry. Wherever he might be, maybe he heard that, who knows. Whoa. That ain't gonna do it. Jerry Lunsford had a show on KWMR called The Hippie from Olima. I think you might have heard that song. Love one another right now. stand. We hold the key to love and peace.
No. Thank you so much, Banana. That was really some wonderful picking and strumming and some of my favorite songs. And that last song especially was, I wish we could all live by it. This is the time we need that song. So the next person up is Shelley Rugg, who's a visual and performing artist from Inverness and often leads us in a sing-along at the end of 10 by 10 shows. Tonight, she's experimenting with the Zoom platform as a performance medium. She is performing through a piece of music called Revival by Beats Antique. So welcome, Shelley.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Leo, you learn something new every day, being the host and trying to remember to share your sound and figure out who's next in the lineup. Okay, here we go. Thank you, everyone. I'm not sure I'm hearing music right now, but I want to introduce the next act, which is Greer.
This is KWMR.
Oh, shoot.
Point Reyes Station. KWMR.
Now I know what happened. Sorry about that, everybody. Okay, on with the show. Coming up next is Greer Ashman. Please welcome Greer Ashman. Greer is a singer, songwriter, and stained glass artist based in Oakland, California. You can check her out on SoundCloud or contact her for more info. Please welcome Greer Ashman.
Thanks. Sweet, softly retreat in our time. The audio on. I just had a freak out that I didn't turn on the audio. Okay. All right. I got two more songs. So this next one is called Bear Valley. So it's got a little bit of a West Marin thing going on, which I thought was pretty special to play for this event, even though I'm playing it in Oakland. So hope you enjoy. This is the last one. We ride on. Thanks, everyone.
Incredible. Absolutely stunning.
All right. Thank you so much, Greer. That was gorgeous. Such a sweet, clear voice. And this is now officially the middle of the show. And normally at the 10 by 10, on the 10 by 10 stage, we would invite an audience member to come up and do a 1 minute performance. I'm not sure if anyone wants to do that. If you know how to raise your hand, let me see. Anyway, I think what we'll do is we'll just skip that for this show because we're obviously on a learning curve, especially me. So what I would like to do is just make a quick announcement and remind everyone to please donate generously to the Dance Palace. You know, it's really tough to run a community center where the whole purpose is for people to gather, and at this time, none of us can do that. So please be generous with the Dance Palace and all of the arts in town, you know, KWMR radio station, Gallery Route 1, Toby's Gallery, all the arts need your support right now. So buy work from artists, invite them to do a private Zoom concert in your own living room. There's all kinds of ways you can support the artists. So thank you so much for showing up tonight for this. And let's move on with the show, shall we?
Right. So on to the second half. And we have the duo of Dinah and Noah Stroe, who perform as Just Us. They're also proud members of the Tamales Bay Mudflats and have performed locally at the Inverness Fair, the Point Reyes Farmers Market, UWMR, and Stockstill House. Catch them weekdays during this quarantine period on Instagram Live by following Noah Stroe. That's Stroe. You can also view clips on YouTube by searching Stroe Porch Fest, one word. So welcome, Dinah and Noah.
Oh. All right. Okay. This is amazing, a very ambitious undertaking, Shelley. And we remember doing this when you first started it, and there were cookies, you could get cookies.
Yeah, we want our cookies. I made apple crisp for after we finished. Ready? This first tune is called
Waltz of
the Little Girls, and of course we dedicate all three of our songs to our wonderful granddaughter, Hazel. Thank you. next is a song in Spanish that we learned through our teacher, Chris Reed, who teaches out of the Freight and Salvage. If anyone's interested in a class of romantic Spanish songs, he's a fabulous teacher.
It's from Mexico.
From Mexico. Old Mexico. Station House terribly. It breaks our hearts. We spent many a wonderful Sunday night hearing wonderful musicians there, and this is a song that we heard Jim Queskin do with Susie Thompson there, and it took our breath away. Can't do it nearly as well as they do, but we still love it. Ready? Listen.
Yeah. See.
With the velvet glove, there's nothing you
twinkle in the sky, darkly blink in my eyes. I wonder why. You don't need analyzing, it's not so surprising. You feel very strange but nice. Your heart goes pitter-patter, I know just what is the matter, 'cause I've been there once or twice. Put your head on my shoulder, you need someone who's older. I rub down with a velvet glove. There's nothing you can take to relieve that plus pain. You're not sick, you're just in love.
Thank you.
Love the dancing. We saw the dancers. All right. Thank you, Dinah and Noah. That was wonderful. And it is so much fun. I had recommended to people to select speaker view for the show, but how heartwarming it is to be able to see everyone enjoying the show from their own homes. So, do what works for you, of course. Coming up next is my co-host, Laura Natkins. Laura is a student of physical theater. Whoops. Zooming on 10 by 10 is the big break that she's been waiting for into the glittering world of digital broadcast. Please welcome Laura Natkins.
Certain times. A wall. Solid. A wall that's unyielding. A wall unmoving. Permanent. A wall. A house. A house, the comforts of home. The comforts of home when things are uncertain, when things are scary, when there are scary things under the bed and in the closets. You never know. You never know what's lurking. You never know what's lurking behind the open door. Thank you.
Yay.
And wishing hats. I'm about to introduce Elizabeth Fenwick. This is Elizabeth's first time at 10 by 10, and she looks forward to doing the real deal in the near future. In the meantime, she loves hearing people's stories and hope you will like hers. She so wishes we could all be cheering each other on together with massive hugs and applause, and next time we will.
Well, hi, everyone. Hey there. I wanted to share a story with you. So in 2007, I was a super happy woman driving off my family farm in Butler, Maryland. I was leaving a lot of old emotional baggage behind me, and had set aside a month to drive cross country. I was headed for the Pacific, looking for a new home. It was fall, and the brilliant colors of Pennsylvania greeted me. I had a really good feeling about this trip. A few of my new friends were heading to Bloomington, Indiana to hear the Dalai Lama talk. I had a feeling this would be a great spot for me to start my trip, so I agreed to meet him there. The very first day was a beautiful morning. But when I woke up, the first thought in my head was, you're going to photograph the Dalai Lama today. I grabbed my backpack, walked out the door, and let my friends know I would meet them at the venue. For the record, Bloomington, Indiana is a gem. It's surrounded by forests. There's artwork wherever you walk through the town. I was having a great day. I took my time. I spent and just wandered with my cameras. I saw the venue in front of me with just a swarm of monks and people. It was crowded, which I love. And I stood in line and was just having a glorious time until I got up to the ticket taker and he said, no photographs. I was so disappointed. I was looking at him and I thought, and I started to talk to him, give him ideas. I usually can talk my way through these situations, but he stood firm, pointed at a pillow, and I mean at a table, and said, you put your backpacks over there. So I went to the back of the line and said to myself, it's time to think this through. So I'm standing in line and I couldn't come up with anything I could say to him. So I walked back to the back of the line. And when I'd get within three people and I didn't know what I had to say, I would start over, go to the back of the line. So as time went by, I realized, okay, I had nothing to work with here. So finally, it was about very few people in the courtyards. So I'm finally, it's me and the ticket taper. And I'm looking at him and I'm going, are you sure I can't bring my cameras in? And he's going, nope, put your cameras, no cameras allowed. So I went and we're both standing there and I couldn't move. I just stood there looking at him. And at that moment, a monk came in into the courtyard and raised his hands in the sky. And he said, the Dalai Lama will start in 15 minutes. And then he paused and he said, the Dalai Lama loves photographs. You can bring in your cameras. So the big guy looks at me and we start laughing. He rolls his eyes and we smile at each other. And with my new friend and my backpack on my back,
this is what happened next.
Thanks for watching. Look forward to giving everybody a big hug at some point in time.
All right, thank you so much, Elizabeth. That was beautiful. And coming up next is Charlie Morgan. As a performing artist in the area musically, on stage and radio for decades, Charlie appreciates 10x10 and its hard workers for a chance to be a ham. Please welcome Charlie Morgan. Charlie, you need to unmute. I don't know why we can't unmute him.
It says I'm
there. You go, Charlie.
Oh, now I'm unmuted.
Now yes, you're good.
Something. Okay. Unmute my, there we go. Hello, everybody. Thank you for being here. And once again, thank you to Shelley and Laura and all the people who do the nuts and bolts work of 10 by 10. This is a historical occasion with 10 by 10 going virtual and Zooming. So I'm glad we're all in on this. A couple of things floated through me while I was sitting around doing the right thing in my house, because you got to do something, right? And I started to think about how important toilet paper was to people. And so this and another little piece about masks came through me, and then maybe we'll do a little singing. Because I saw a scene where people were sitting at a blackjack table and the dealer asked them to place their bets. So they took out three rolls of toilet paper and put it down in front of the dealer. Anyway, this is called TP and Me. Roll, roll, rock with your roll. But the rolls are getting rare because the shelves are always bare. Through the store, you can stroll to look for another roll. And the wipes are getting wiped out because that guy with the last one gave a triumphant shout. With a wobbly economy, TP is the new currency. Hoarding can't be beat when you're on the edge of that seat. $2 trillion in money? No, TP is the new currency. The other day I did a Zoom with some people, and just like tonight, one of the things that I appreciate is that I can see your whole faces because you don't have masks on. It's amazing, like we're people from outer space, all of us, you know, walking around talking through our masks, but that masks also inspired this. Masks, masks. We asked for masks. So I won't breathe on you, and you won't breathe on me. And it covers your halitosis, which is usually the grossest. All you know of me are my eyes, as you can see, and keep 6 feet away so we can make it through the day. Whoops, you're only 5. Don't give me that distance jive. And we all can't meet in a bunch, because now going to lunch is out to lunch. We treat us like we're bad. These rules are driving me mad. Masks on, we speak with our eyes and sparkle and smile because our eyes tell no lies. Stay indoors with crazed nerve so we can flatten the curve. In baseball, a flat curveball ends up over the fence, but with a virus, a flat curve makes a lot of sense. With masks, we all look like bandits ready to steal, but masks show us to be right and real. The importance of ears to put some masks on right has definitely grown. Tough for Vincent van Gogh, for he only one ear did he own. So stay inside, don't wander too much in town, and let's not just flatten the curve, let's stomp that sucker down. Now, one of the things that happens when we're all concentrating on something important like the coronavirus is that we can be distracted from other things that are going on in the world, for better or worse. We're still fighting in at least 1.5 wars, and nobody's talking about it too much because we're all trying to do the right thing health-wise. So I'm gonna lay down my sword and shield, down by, sing it with me, down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by
the riverside, I'm gonna lay down my heart, huh? Down by the riverside, down by the
river no more. I ain't gonna study no war no more. I ain't gonna study no war no more.
No more. I ain't
study no war no more. I ain't gonna study no war no more. Gonna walk with the people of peace down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside. I'm gonna walk with the people of peace down by the riverside. Ain't gonna study no war no more. I ain't gonna study no war no more. Ain't gonna study no war no more. Ain't gonna study no war no more. I also want to thank Ken Adams for taking the aptitude of computer Zoom science and trying to put it into my performer's brain. Thank you very much.
All right, Charlie. Awesome. I love hearing your poems. For our last act of the evening, number 10, is the Zach and Whit Band. Whitney and Zach are a husband and wife duo currently based in Lincoln, Nebraska, where they run online music lesson studio, zspguitar.com. They recently held a Zoom concert of their own, in which they performed a concert comprised entirely of music composed since the shelter-in-place orders started to go into effect. Today, they are performing as many of those songs as the 10 minutes will allow. Please welcome the Zach and Whit Band. Website address is their name.
Apex of human history and the turn of a new decade, everyone was quite comfortable. Dogs had rights, jobs were filled by the next in line, and children were their teachers' problems. Food was plentiful, water available, and toilet paper was on the shelves. Out of the bounty erupted a virus that seemed to emerge only to remind us. Thank you. Human, and we've written all of these pieces since March 13th when we first started sheltering in place here. And we're just sort of excited to share the experience as it was and still is. We're hoping to do two more, and this next one's a short little, hopefully you were dancing on it, a short little dance tune that we call Higher Place. So join us here. Get on up and move.
Take me to a higher place.
one's weekends.
That was fantastic, Zach and Whitney. Thanks for joining us all the way from Nebraska. And we're so excited that you're going to be moving back to California real soon. Yay. That was fantastic. All right, we're at the end of the show. Thank you for coming and supporting our 10x10 performers. And thank you so much for coming out to support the Dance Palace. If you haven't donated to them yet, please visit dancepalace.org to do so. And I'm pretty sure Claire Peasley put a link to the Dance Palace right in the chat, so you can check that out. Laura.
Yeah, sorry. If you'd like to be on the 10x10 email list, go to 10x10performancelab.com to sign up. And I hope you all will. The next show is Sunday, July 26th, and will likely be on Zoom again. Join our email list to be notified. Again, that's 10x10performancelab.com.
Could we all unmute and clap for you guys and everybody?
Yeah. Let us finish our closing announcements, and then the answer will be yes.
Yes.
A big thank you to you, our wonderful audience, and especially to the Dance Pals and Ken Adams for tech support for tonight's show. And now, we'd love to hear any feedback about any of the performances you saw tonight. If you'd like to make a comment, unmute now.
Okay.
Here. Woo-hoo! Yay! Woo-hoo! Awesome.
And I'd say, if you want to make a specific comment, why don't you raise your hand so you don't all talk at once?
I know. I thought about raising the hand, but we can only see like a third of the people at a time.
Okay.
No, there is, but oh, you mean like, oh, that's me.
Someone's got a little feedback.
Yeah.
Shelley, is there any way that we can see the audience?
Is he in jail?
You have to go to gallery view, and then you can see the audience.
Okay, thank you.
And then there's little arrows to the right or left that'll let you see
other people.
A lot of people have their video turned off, but if you want to turn your video on now, everybody, so we can all say hi to you, that would be beautiful.
Mute. Okay.
A big thank you to Banana for joining us tonight. Super special. I mean, I don't know about everyone, but there were a lot of special moments this evening, I thought. I'm really thrilled how this show went tonight. Thanks for being here, everyone.
Yay, Shelley.
Yeah. Thank you, Shelley. Thank you, everyone.
And
thank
Laura.
You.
And Ken Adams, who's behind the scenes. Ken helped all the performers do their sound checks ahead of time and really helped make the show sound good as it can on Zoom without those. No control of any freezing moments.
that worked out okay.
Oh, it did. It worked out, I think, better than okay.
Yeah, really well.
So, Malati Shanazi raised hand. Malati, what do you want to say?
First, my name is pronounced Malati.
Thank you.
With quality. And I want to thank you all. In here in Hawaii, we have so little in terms of this kind of opportunity. And I of course came on to see my daughter, Greer Ashman, but then stayed for the entire concert. And I'm really because the variety it thrilled me, and I can't wait till July so I come back and watch you all, whoever's there, again. And so thank you all. I do a lot of Zoom for business, and one hint is anybody who chooses a background from the green screen, like not your real background, like the wall, whatever's behind you. What happens is when you move, you actually, part of your body gets cut off. So that's part of your performance. It's perfect. If it's not part of your performance, then we don't see you. And Shelley, I actually was like really amazed at how it worked for you, even though I wanted to see like your whole face, but then half of your face would go away. And that's something that I've learned I would like.
Well, I actually, I did do it on purpose. I liked the effect, and yeah. I wanted to play with that.
Yeah, yeah, you did. And so as I got into it, it was like, how cool. Look at this.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, the bummer for me was tech, because I forgot to share my sound, so I was moving without the music for the 2/3 of the piece. So, oh well. Thank you for your comments. That was fabulous. And my friend Jen wanted me to let everyone know that the screen behind me was actually from one of my paintings.
Oh, fabulous.
Let's see. Jeffrey, you wanted to say something.
Oh, Shelley, very courageous. It's like trying to put a square peg in a round hole, because this platform is not for performing, right? Mm-hmm. So we as artists have to resort to using this platform, and lots and lots and lots of tricks, you know? Lots of tricks, and very, very, very hard, because if each individual artist doesn't have their space set up and their sound all set, it's real bumpy. And, you know, we've been working on this platform, and it's also really difficult to mix all the artists with the audience, right? That's kind of tough as well. And so a lot is lost, but a lot is gained. And so you have to look at the spirit of getting together, but certainly a lot is lost of, you know, the applause and things like that, you know, and getting the feedback. And, you know, there we go. There's Aurora. They're applauding over there. That's all. Great. Keep at it. Keep at it.
Thanks, Jeffrey. I just want to say, I want to come back to Greer. Greer Ashman, just such a pure, beautiful voice you have. And to see the stained glass in the background was gorgeous.
Thank you so much. Thanks. Yeah. It felt really good. I'm pleasantly surprised how well this turned out. And also just the experience of seeing other people's art via this medium has been really touching in a way that I didn't really expect, not being in the same place. So really cool to connect with everybody this way.
Thank you. Yeah, somebody accidentally shared their screen, I guess, so. Mm-hmm. And Emily, wow, you know, you brought such an amazing environment and quirkiness, and there were so many visual images that you created that were really memorable, I felt.
Thank you.
Emily. How you doing, Em?
Who's talking?
Pretty crazy. That sounded like Jeffrey.
Okay.
Thank you, Shelley, and for all the support. Yeah, the whole thing of having the support technically was really neat. It was really neat experience. A lot of fear and nervousness, and fun to improv under those conditions. I'm really glad it's over, and I had a great time.
Who's that?
Thanks, Emily.
Thank you.
And
but you know, Shelley,
you know, I really want to say I'm proud of Laura Natkins. That was awesome, Laura. You really did it. Good job.
Ten by ten is really a platform for diversity, mm-hmm, in performing, and it's wonderful that way. So thank you,
Charlie. Oh, and of course, all the performances tonight, I'm really thrilled. Starting off with that lovely dance in the woods. And let's just, birds. Yeah, you can hear the birds chirping in the background. That was beautiful. And of course, Banana. Oh, and Dinah and Noah, it was so fun listening to you guys play and watch Aura and James dancing in the background. That was really sweet. And Elizabeth, you know, hearing your story and seeing the pictures that you managed to take
some kind of mystical moment. That was fantastic. And Charlie, of course, love hearing your poetry. And then, you know, Zach and Whitney, wow, way to close out the show. That was fantastic. Anybody else have anything they want to add?
I think the quality was just over the top. You know, all the music was quite wonderful. I think it came across quite well. And I think we should all be proud of ourselves.
Definitely.
Put on a good show.
Yeah. And I think that the process worked really well to have that tech rehearsal thing before, yeah. Shelley, because actually it took off without a hitch this week, you know, and it would have been challenging had we not checked in a couple of weeks prior.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. And nice to have the feedback also from Ken for the AV stuff.
Having the support of the Dance Palace and Ken was super helpful, especially for this first adventure. So yeah. thank you.
And thank God.
And Bonnie.
Support.
Yeah, Bonnie.
Bonnie hiding out there.
Yeah, I'm hiding back here. You can't see me too well. but I just really want to thank you. This was actually my first opportunity to attend a 10 by 10. And this was just amazing. And I love the fact that it was so great to get everybody together online. It sort of felt like being in the Dance Palace without being at the Dance Palace. And I just really appreciate everyone's support in doing this one as a fundraiser for us. And we've all been talking about how to make more events online. And this was a really great way to see how things are gonna work and how they can work. And I'm just gonna put a plug in for supporting you guys. And also if folks have ideas of events they might want to do online through the Dance Palace to let us know.
All right, thanks Bonnie. And Aura, you wanted to say something?
Yes. Yes, hi, thank you so much for the opportunity. And I wanted to say in Spanish because some people of my family are here and they don't know English, so I just want to say gracias a todos por estar acá, aquellos que están desde México aquí. Si no fuera por Zoom, no habría esta posibilidad, así que gracias por estar acá. Y lo siento si hay la mitad de las cosas que no entiendes, pero gracias por hacer el esfuerzo de venir. I'm saying that thank you for Zoom and for this, the blessing of COVID is that I was able to share this with my family across the river, you know, like in the other country. So I think it's a blessing to have this opportunity of Zoom. Thank you.
And I'd like to say that we have many newcomers today to 10 by 10. And I hope that when all of this is over, when we resume meeting in the Dance Palace, when we resume our show in the Dance Church, that people will continue to come. Because it's even better in person.
This is true. We can have sing-alongs in person.
You can have sing-alongs.
Yeah, unfortunately on Zoom.
Oh, cookies. Remember we always had cookies at the end.
Did I say something?
And cookies. True.
I did, three times.
And hugs. Don't forget the hugs.
Oh, the hugs. Yeah. Which we are
But I think the biggest thing that's missing, and maybe we can do something about this, is just the reaction of the audience, you know, hearing the applause, hearing the laughter. And Laura, you know, for one example, people were making comments about, oh, they wish that you could hear them giggling because, you know, people are having their reactions and the performer is missing that part of it.
Right.
So, but, you know, it's a new realm. Teresa.
Shelley, you are amazing. I'm just so inspired by your creativity and just going for it and figuring it out. And everyone, I mean, I come whenever I can, and it's really special. This is a whole new way of being, and everyone was stunning. It really was. The diversity, the richness, and the creativity that's coming out of your homes and being with the waves of emotion and just finding a new way. I am just blown away. I'm full of gratitude. I plan on donating to the Dance Palace.
Yay.
I hope other people do as well. And thank you, everyone. Our hearts to your hearts.
And we are donating already and will continue to do so. And thank you, Shelley, and everybody else. You guys are awesome. And people attending from far away, isn't that amazing? So great. So.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we got Wisconsin in the house, Nebraska, New York. Yeah,
we can go for the big one.
Hawaii.
That's wonderful.
Yeah, you guys can just shout it out where you are.
That's a great idea.
So great.
Hilo, Hawaii.
Tulsi.
Hawaii.
Brooklyn, New York.
So cool. Connersville, Wisconsin.
Yay. Ooh, somebody typed in the chat. Singapore.
Whoa.
Who's that?
Joel.
I think we don't have that many people left, but who is
Inverness?
Inverness Park.
All right.
Woodacre.
Okay. Oh, that's Ken. He's from Woodacre.
And Mexico. Gracias. Oh, me gusta mucho Mexico. Fantastic. Yes.
All right. Well, this was really special, everybody. Thank you so much. All the performers who came on board and jumped into this situation and learned new things. Thank you. Thank you to Ken again for being there to support us along the way. Really, really helped reduce the stress level quite a bit. And thank you, Bonnie, for backing everything up. And we hope everyone is really generous with the Dance Palace. We all need help now and then, and it's the Dance Palace's turn. So let's help.
Where's the
right?
Oh, thank you.
Beautiful.
All right. Well, Zach and Whit, you want to give us an encore, and then make everybody jealous who left early.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
Good night song, perhaps.
I love putting you on the spot.
Yeah, they're young. You can do it.
Come on! Don't just smile at me. Oh, unmuted.
We've torn down all the gear. That's why I'm sitting in the dark.
Oh, okay. Let's hear an acapella. Come on, Whitney.
How about singing a good night song?
I don't know any of those.
Shelley? Shelley, no one?
Well, Dinah offered to play.
Oh, hit it, Dinah.
You could.
She's muted. She's muted.
Oh,
I'm muted.
Here we go.
$100. There's a caveat there. I'll play if someone donates $100 to the Dance Palace.
There you go.
Whoa.
That's good.
I'm waiting.
You want to grab my ukulele?
You're talking about it.
Going once, going twice, and still two ladies.
We'll sing a song in Yiddish if you pay $100.
All right.
Okay, we'll do it in Spanish for $100.
Well, we're down to 27.
I'll do $25 if there are three more people for 25. Oh, there you go, Laura.
Love it. That is so great, auctioning off late night songs. That's great.
Anyone else for 25?
Fabulous.
Nope.
Who else put in
the 25? You have to decide what language you want. Ah, the language.
Señor.
I will get more people for $25.
Pay up. Pay up.
What?
Okay.
What is it?
What do we do in Spanish? Oh, we'll do Las Gaviotas.
No, no. What do we do?
Elizabeth. Thanks for being here.
Okay. We have a song ready. You just got to pay for it.
Oh, really?
I'll pay afterwards.
Oh, I trust you. I trust you. We'll do a song. I trust you. I trust you.
For it.
You think I work for KQED or something, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Is this a Peruvian song, Noah?
Yeah.
Oh, this is from Noah's Madre Patria. Oops. Hold on. Okay. Sorry, the light is. Can you hear? Hold on. Technical difficulties. Can you hear us? Richards. He said he'll give $50 for Yiddish.
Oh.
Are we into that? All right. One more in Yiddish?
Yiddish.
Okay. This is a good one. Just love it. I'm getting hot. I have to take off my sweater. Sorry.
Oh. Wow.
I promised all my friends who are real professional musicians that when this is all over, we're going back to the peanut gallery. But for now, we're having some fun. Okay. What ready, Noah? We're doing Shame the Vune.
Thank you.
geschickt, mein Glück hab ich gefunden, als ich hab dich gewonnen. Chains wie Toys in Sonnen, aus mein Herz geglickt. Deine Zähne lag weiße helle Lach, mit deinen schönen Augen, deine helle Lach, deine Hände lang, hast mich zugezeugen, Chain wie die Lewone, lichtig wie die Stern von Himmel. Lovely as the moon, bright shining as the stars, you are like a precious gift sent from heaven above. My luck, it walked right in on the day I met you. You shine like a thousand stars, you light up my life. Oh, those pearly teeth, oh, that curly hair, oh, those gleaming eyes. Charmed from head to toe, how was I to know you'd pull me in so deeply? Shein wie die Lewone, lichtig wie die Stern von Himmel am Atone, bist mir zugeschickt.
Nice. All right. Well, I think I'm going to be the one to say, well, thank you, of course, once again. Thank you, Dinah and Noah, for taking money for the Dance Palace. And thanks, everybody, for coming. And those of you who are still here, thanks for sticking around. I don't know about you guys, but I'm kind of tired.
Yeah. Thanks so much for doing this. It was really special.
Great.
Yeah. We can all go outside and howl a little bit now and hear each other maybe.
Jack and Rob, thank you, Stroes. Love sure. The song.
Good night to everybody.
Good night, everyone.
Good night. Thank you.
Bye.
From Susan and Lauren, thanks for the encore. That's nice.
Yes, thanks, everybody.
I'm going to end the meeting now.
Okay. All right, Ken. It's been great.
All right, thank you, Ken. So much.